complete paraplegia who used to walk with KFOs and walker. Now he got improved power in his lower limb. So we initiated walking him with elbow crutches and bilateral AFO. When we started making him with elbow crutches and AFO, we planned to teach him one side bar and one side of elbow crutches. Once he gained the endurance and balance, we progressed towards bilateral elbow crutches. In his condition, he got a good power in his right leg and there was a fair power in the left lower limb. That's why when he is keeping a step, right side is controlled and he is getting heel pattern, but in left side he swings and do it because the fair quadriceps power, he using the hip muscles to move forward and lock it with a force, and he has been walking. You can see this is a type of walking 4-point gait. He uses elbow crutches differently and the legs in a different manner. So this is called 4-point gait with elbow crutches and AFO. Even the weight bearing is small difference is there because of the muscle power changes. Direct transfer. The person who used to walk with elbow crutches or walker, the basic thing to teach them how to sit to stand from the bed or from the cot. See, this is alteration. When the patient has a difference in the lower limb power, he could able to walk in the elbow crutches, but sometime we feel it is not safe because when he swing the legs and moving forward, when he's turning, he used to lose balance and able to fall. So what we did is we tried with an axillary crutches. With the axillary crutches, the advantage is weight bearing is going through your axilla, so trunk is shifting the weight towards the crutches. That in elbow crutches we are using our upper limb to hold the weight bearing. So here it is very safer, but there is some disadvantages with it. The axillary crutches, the bar is in the axilla. In future it may lead up to a crutch palsy. Or so what we do is, rather they were using a pad, axillary pad in the axilla, we used to teach them to use it in the front part of the chest so that weight bearing won't be go into a axillary part. It doesn't compress the nerve which is coming there. So you can ask the person to use the axillary pad in front of your chest to bear the weight. As I talked about the transfer, if you try to make him stand by using axillary crutches, there is one more technique. The person can even use a bilateral axillary crutches with one hand and can hold the bed and come out. In his condition, it is difficult because he got a fair lower limb power in the leg. One side it is good, but the other side it is not good. That's why he is going for a fall. But if sometime if you are trained and he is being supported with a mild assistance, he may able to come to stand and he may able to walk in a nice manner. But concerning with the complications of crutch palsy and about the transfer needs support, it might be difficult. On the other hand, you see with the elbow crutches, he could able to do the transfers in a safer manner. This technique, when we are performing, you can try elbows and shoulders should be in a 90 degree of angle. So this 90 degree of angle will be helpful to hold the elbow crutches in a straight to the floor, or we call it as perpendicular to the floor, so that it will be weight bearing will be equal and he can able to ascend even with a fair power in the one limb. Only careful thing has to be do is the elbow crutch should be straight to the floor. It shouldn't go inside the cot or something, so that when it may tip forwardly, so you have to keep it straight to your arm so that there won't be no slips and fall. If you compare both the things, elbow crutches is safe and direct transfer is independent compared to the axillary crutches.